In the last episode, we discovered the graphics pipeline and started drawing on a square window. First, let's try to make this window resizable. We called GL viewport at the beginning of the main function for clarity. The viewport is a rectangle area on which the graphics pipeline will operate when drawing. Its corners correspond to the positions -1, -1, 1, -1, 1, 1, and -1, 1 in normalized coordinates. It is defined by its x and y offsets in pixels from the default lower left corner, and its width and height dimensions in pixels. When we attached the GL context to our SDL2 window, the viewport was set to no offsets and width and height equal to the ones of our window. Now, if we simply call .resizable on the window builder when creating it, the window will successfully be resizable, but the viewport will still be the same square. Note that, however the viewport is defined, calling glClear to clear the color will clear the whole frame buffer or window, which is not limited to the viewport size. To fix the viewport being the same all the time, whenever a window resize event occurs, we can call glViewport again, with no offsets and width and height dimensions matching the ones of the new window. Those new dimensions are present among the SDL2 event data. Now, the viewport always matches the inner size of the window. This way, the sun is always contained in the window. However, the drawing is stretched on resize because our viewport isn't a square anymore. What I want is to keep the viewport the inner size of the window to be able to see anything that is drawn on the area of the window and to unstretch the drawing. Let's keep that problem at the back of our minds and discover uniforms. Uniforms allow us to send data from the application to GPU readable memory, readable by every programmable shader. In objects.rs, create a new struct for them, uniform, with an ID of type glint, a signed integer. Add a constructor method, new, to this struct that will take in the ID of the program in which the uniform name is used and the name of the uniform we are looking for. Call glGetUniformLocation with the program and the name of the uniform as a C string. If the name is not found in any shader of that program after all compiled, then glGetUniformLocation will return -1. In this case, return an error. Otherwise, return OK with a new instance of our uniform struct. But why is that useful for our window resize problem? Well, with uniforms, we can pass data relative to the resolution of the viewport to shaders. This means the vertex shader will be able to change the position of every vertex in a way that will unstretch what is being drawn. From main.rs, create a uniform with the earlier constructor that will look for a uniform variable named u_resolution. It will contain two float values, the width and the height of the viewport. To set their value, call glUniform2f for two floats with the uniform ID or location and two floats, the width and height of the viewport. Update these values every time the viewport is resized, so after creating the window and every time the window is resized, with the width and height of the resize event. Declare this uniform in the vertex shader in the global scope with the uniform keyword. Two floats correspond to a vec2. The uniform name must match the one we provided to glGetUniformLocation. In the main function, create a variable uv equal to the vertex input position. Modify this uv variable. If the width is bigger than the height of the viewport, pull vertices horizontally towards the center by giving the scale of the y-axis to the x-axis. Otherwise, pull vertices vertically towards the center and give the scale of the x-axis to the y-axis. And return this UV value instead of the initial position. This will cause the effect wanted earlier, where minus 1 to 1 represents the same distance in pixels for both axes. And drawing outside of the middle square will still be seen as long as it's in the viewport. If we try it, the sun is successfully contained at the center and unstretched. Keep in mind, uniforms can contain any data we want to pass to shaders. This viewport trick is just one use case of them. Let's see one more, a time uniform, which is very common. Create another uniform to update the color of the sun. Call it u_time and set its value every frame to the time elapsed since the loop started. We'll use it to make the star color cycle. To make it a tiny bit more real, change the color around the sun to a very dark gray. In the Fragment Shader, declare this uniform. Create a variable, sun_lifetime, that will be u_time_6, so the color, over time, will not actually cycle as stars don't, but will instantly go back to the color of a star that is just born. Change the red, green, and blue color channels to an expression that depends on sun_lifetime in some way, in order to make it go through light blue, orange, and then red. For those interested in creating amazing things with a Fragment Shader, I'll try to make a video, or series, on it at some point. But for now, you can check out the book of shaders, link in the description. In main.rs, add a modulo to the number of sides to go repeatedly from 3 to 8 sides. And debug. No trailing commas in GLSL. That's it. See you next time.